After centuries of exploration, there is still one realm that remains in darkness, a place that is untouched, a place in China. Caves are formed by limestone, the only type of soluble rock. China contains about 1 million square kilometers of exposed limestone, about half of the total amount on Earth. Yunnan, in southwest China, has 40% of its landscape covered by limestone. This is known as karst landscape. With the numerous caves formed millions of years ago, very few of them were documented. In China, caves have been used for centuries as shelter and storage for humans to sustain life and culture. The earliest documentation of caves dates back 400 years to when Xu Xieke, China's first celebrated explorer, recorded some of them in his travel journal. Locals today take caves for granted and exploit them as tourist attractions. Unfortunately, they do not realize the need to study them. The Yunnan caves have attracted tourists from all over China, and their profits are in the millions. The first tourist cave in Yunnan is known as the Alu Ancient Cave, and it opened in 1987. Alu is one of the sub-tribes of the Yi ethnic group. They used to live in this 18-cave system for generations. Today, the Alu people have transformed their former habitat into colorful and entertaining spaces, representing their concepts of liveliness and prosperity. The cave in the Zhujiang Scenic Region is the most popular cave in Yunnan today. Zhujiang is 90 kilometers from Kunming, the capital city of Yunnan.
阿鲁古洞的话，它比九乡应该说早开发了10年左右吧。那么肯定它在刚开始开发的时候有很多先进的经验。 这个我们肯定向他们借鉴过很多，但是因为我们九乡它是距离省会昆明最近的一座以溶洞景观为主的国家级重点风景名胜区，像在阿鲁古洞的话，可能看的比较多的是钟乳石，但是呢，来到九乡不但可以看到钟乳石，可以看到它的资源非常丰富。
Both the Alu and Zhujiang caves are bathed with lights that reflect the dominant sense of beauty in the Chinese tradition. The cave's developers leveled the original ground with cement pathways to make the caves more accessible. The developers fabricated myths and imposed their own creative interpretations of the cave's natural forms. What used to be the home of the ancient Yi people is just a place for the tourists to take photographs and buy souvenirs today. And this superficial way of utilizing the caves has significantly improved revenues and benefits the local economy.
九乡的旅游业呢，可以说是我们宜良县的一个支柱产业。近两年，每年的客流量保持在70万人以上，年的综合收入在6000万左右。我们九乡有句宣传语说：“不由九乡往来云南。”
The sheer beauty of the caves makes an impression on the visitors.
The
洞很宏伟，很壮观，是我所见到的最漂亮的一个洞。最大的特点就是有一条水，我觉得这比较好。七彩岩石那些景观大体差不多，就是那个。
Tourists are intoxicated by the astonishing sights. But what else do they know beyond the surface beauty? Chang Fan is the vice president of the Geographical Research Center of Yunnan, as well as head of the caving department of the China Exploration and Research Society, or CERS. He shares his insights on the problem of lighting the caves.
In China, Yunnan, and other provinces, 它的缺陷呢，一个呢是用能量很高的灯泡，这样就成本就上升了。另外一个呢，太多的彩色各种颜色的灯光，当然这是我们亚洲人喜欢的大红大绿、热闹喜庆。但是呢，应该是有的洞穴的地段应该是用白炽灯，让游客可以看得到洞穴岩石的原始风貌是什么样的。太多的灯光呢，当然就意味着 本来一个漆黑黑暗的洞穴里边呢，产生了灯光呢，就带来光合作用，就改变了它的整个生物链、生态系统都改变了。所以，灯光上是一个洞穴的灵魂所在。The
lighting problem does not seem to dampen the enthusiasm of tourists to visit, or the local government's appetite for developing additional caves in the region. After the financial success of Alu and Jiuxiang, more than 30 caves have been exploited in this small region over the past 20 years. However, most of these new developments did not offer an improved touristic experience over Alu and Jiuxiang. Most failed and closed down. There are still many wonders beyond the bright and colorful lights to humans, but cave animals can dwell in the darkness without eyes.
We 就有31种，全中国的洞穴鱼类现在报道的就63种。那么云南的这么一个小的区域里面，占到全国总数的一半。到现在来讲的话，大多数我们定义的洞穴鱼类的话，基本上都是眼睛是高度退化或者是完全消失。通常我们发现的洞穴鱼类都是一个洞一个种，而且这个种的话呢，就是这个洞的特有种。 而在非常特殊的例外，就是云南宜良的九乡这个溶洞，在它地下河里面会发现有两种鱼类，而且
恰好这两种鱼类都属于我们中国的洞穴鱼类的两大类群，一个是鲤类，一个是秋类。鲤鱿的开发对这个洞穴鱼类可以说有正面的作用，也有负面的作用。所谓正面的作用，就是说它作为旅游开发了之后呢，这个洞穴的鱼类是它的这个观赏的一部分。旅游洞穴的管理部门它会
主动的保护这条鱼类不被捕捞啊等等，它会限制这个。但是呢，旅游的这个游客在洞穴里面走动的脚步声，还有这个比如说船啊等等这些碰撞的声音，对洞穴鱼类的影响会非常的敏感。因为洞穴的鱼类它对光线不敏感，但是它对震动是极其的敏感，会让他们受惊吓，也影响他们的这个正常的日常的这个生活，那么这个是它负面的影响。
Cave fish originated from freshwater fish that were brought into the caves by water streams millions of years ago. As water flows through these caves, it brings in fauna and flora, which over time adapt to the dark cave environment. The existence of such rare ecosystems has ignited great enthusiasm in the study and exploration of caves, known as speleology.
在一次偶然的机会当中呢，听当地的彝族人，他们说这里有一个洞，叫大石洞。这里的地貌呢是一个盲谷，河流从沿着这个山谷流进来以后呢，就到这个洞穴里边就一直的流下去了，就形成这个洞穴。洞口的这一部分呢，空间很大，可以看得出在很古老的时候，它形成的时候呢，发生过很多。进来了100多米以后，再往下边走进去呢，崩塌就很小，那么整个地下水呢就充满了洞穴的一半，再进去呢就会有一些真正只生活在洞穴里边的小动物，像灶马，就像地表的那个蟋蟀一样的动物在里边，还有一些马鹿这样的动物在里边。这个地方呢，我们初步调查呢，没有发现什么古人类的活动的痕迹，也当地也没有用它来做旅游的开发。我们也了解到，昆明离一个城市那么近的洞穴呢，还可以保护的还很好，没有受到很多的破坏，所以这个也是一个安慰。
In addition to these horizontal caves formed by collapsing hard rock, the vertical cave offers cavers an opportunity to seek new records of depth.
This thing we should be 6 years ago.六年前就发现了，这个天坑的形成呢，是属于它那个地下以前就有一个洞穴系统，然后呢，它就在不停地崩塌，不停地在崩塌，到顶面上它呢，它就支撑不住那个这个力，所以整个大的面积就崩塌下去，就形成这个天坑的一个状态了。那么这个天坑底下呢，下去以后还有一个水道向那个方向去了。那么底下呢还有一些地下的湖啊，还有几种，有两种比较珍稀的鱼类都是从这个洞里面发现的。
The Anchazi cave shaft is approximately 91 meters deep and 54 meters in diameter, enough to accommodate a 30-story building. At the base of the cave lies a rich, untouched natural resource.One major issue with cave exploration in China is the lack of cavers willing to explore the countless undiscovered caves. The CERS cavers train and educate young enthusiasts.
This kind of 探险呢，就跟普通的这种平洞的探险就不一样。那么这种呢，多数都是。一般来说一定是需要那个绳索技术，就是我们叫的 SRT 这个 单绳上升下降的技术。如果经过不了这个培训，这来探这些洞的话，就非常非常危险。
The features of this vertical cave have allowed CERS cavers to turn its small shaft into a training center for younger cavers. After students master their skills here, they are ready to explore the Yunnan caves and contribute to speleology in China. Yunnan locals have begun to protect their caves and to recycle them into places to practice their traditions. In a small Yi village near the town of Xilin, a young village chief has created a business by protecting the caves. The three-mouthed cave features a natural chimney, which originally served as a natural kitchen. The Yi people used to stay over and cook here while guarding their farmlands during the sowing season. After a simple renovation, the cave was transformed into a barbecue cave.
就是两个山洞，这我们还没有开发之前，村民嘛，有些他就把那个他的乱七八糟那些垃圾的都堆到里面去了，然后就是还有在前几年嘛，附近的那个他们。西江的那个石头就三个地方弄那个石头嘛，如果我们不开发的话，很可能会被破坏掉。
A few steps away, there's another cave that resonates with a great hollow sound, attracting many young Yi couples during the courting season. The natural echo effect in the cave provides the young couples with a superb natural stage to sing their love songs to each other. As a result,This cave has been converted into a karaoke cave. The natural wine cellar at the back of the cave is used to store the homemade rice wine that really impresses local wine critics.
那个阿里古镇那个，它只是一个景观而已，就看过了就过了，当然会留下很深的印象，特别对那个外地游客来说。但这个呢，它更有那个它内涵，有其他的东西在里面。
The Yi village value of these caves.But sometimes to the detriment of natural native life.
Inside, there are many bears in there. Sometimes, when they sing songs and dance, the bears will also come out. Maybe they were scared, disturbed their life. They came out. Maybe they were trying to come out and dance with people, something like that.
The great modern achievement in this field dates back to 1960, when the deepest known cave on Earth, the Voronya Cave in Georgia, Eastern Europe, was discovered. After studying abroad in the 1980s, Chiang Fan and his fellow explorers pioneered modern speleology in China.Over the past 20 years, the explorers from CERS have discovered more than 100 caves in Yunnan. Speleology is a multidisciplinary science. It is essential to anthropology and geographical studies, as many ethnic groups in China have long histories with caves. The CERS explorers have discovered new species of cave animals like blind fish, cave insects, and even found fossils of ancient pandas. Their efforts have enabled zoologists and biologists to develop a greater understanding of cave ecology. Chang Fan's team has also discovered inside the caves the remains of ancient mining trails. These findings provide anthropologists with crucial supporting evidence for their study of ethnic groups in the region. Despite CERS work in Yunnan, there are still many more caves to be explored and studied. A major concern is finding a balance between exploitation and conservation.
In the caves, there are two large-scale, large-scale caves, one is Yunnan的九香的溶洞，还有一个第二个叫阿鲁古洞。这两个洞穴我觉得基本上从洞穴的地貌来讲景观来讲基本上已经代表了云南洞穴的一个非常典型的数量的增加不会再增加景观上的可观赏性所以说呢也我认为就是说在增加数量开发新的洞穴的话呢从现在来看的话也不会增加更多的旅游客源所以呢我认为从保护洞穴鱼类的角度和保护洞穴生物的角度来讲的话呢这两个洞穴的开发作为理由已经足以不宜再开发新的洞穴
Discovering the true value of these caves requires a few explorers guiding the way.
I'm a 探险家呢实际他比平时的人呢去很多一般平时的人不能到达的地方那么所以呢为什么做探险的人一定是一个保护主义者应该是责任为什么因为你去到的地方别人可能再也去不到了你没有任何理由把它破坏了而且你还应该把这种保护的意识告诉给后边要去的人应该怎么保护好它那么我觉得一个探险者啊，这一点是最起码的一个素质。
There is still much to explore in the caves of China and Asia. Exploration and conservation go hand in hand, and the result of this balance provides us with new insights. Maybe one day our knowledge of caves will light the way into this mysterious world of darkness that remains the Earth's final frontier.